In this lesson, you will learn how to create custom dialog boxes, which are often called user forms. Most of the previous lessons have discussed concepts that are common to all computer languages. All languages have variables, if structures, loops, and so on. One advantage VBA has over many other languages is that it allows you to easily create graphical user interfaces with user forms. You can create user forms in the Visual Basic Editor by clicking on Insert, User Form. You also can create user forms by right-clicking in the VBA project window, selecting Insert, and User Form. A blank user form named UserForm 1 has appeared, along with a toolbox palette. The properties of the user form appear in the Properties window, and an icon for the user form has appeared in the VBA project window. We can customize the user form by changing its properties. This particular user form will be used to calculate the height of a ball that is thrown vertically from a building, so the user form's name and caption should reflect this. We'll change the user form's name to Height Calc and change the user form's caption to Height Calculator. When we want to refer to the user form later on, we use its name. The name, which we call Height Calc, cannot contain any spaces. And notice that the name of the user form has changed at the top of the Properties window and in the VBA Project window. The name of the caption is Height Calculator, and this is what appears at the top of our user form. Currently, our user form is blank. We need to add areas where the user can input values for the initial height of the ball, the initial velocity of the ball, and the time since the ball was thrown. There also should be labels that tell the user where to input those three pieces of information. After our program calculates the height of the ball, we also should have a location where we can display it to the user. And finally, we'll need two buttons that will allow the user to execute the program and quit the program. We add all these items, which are called controls, to the user form using the toolbox palette. Since the last item I clicked on was the properties window, the toolbox palette is temporarily hidden. But if I click on the user form, the toolbox palette appears. Some of the most common user form controls are labels, which are messages that help guide the user. Text boxes, which allow the user to input data and can be used to give output to the user. Command buttons, which are buttons that allow the user to execute a set of statements every time they're clicked. Check boxes, which allow the user to select or unselect an item. Option buttons and combo boxes both allow the user to select one item out of many options. When using option buttons, all possible options will be displayed on the user form at the same time. For this reason, option buttons are more often used when only a few options exist. A combo box is a drop-down menu which lists the options when clicked on. They are more often used when many options exist. We first are going to create a text box that will allow the user to enter the initial height of the ball. Let's first enlarge the user form, and we go to our toolbox palette, select text box, go to the user form, and click and drag on the user form to the desired size for the text box. Next, we'll enter a descriptive name for the text box in the name field of the properties window. I will name the text box Init Height, which stands for initial height. we can adjust the position of the text box by clicking on it and moving it. We should place a label next to the text box that will let the user know that the initial height of the ball should be placed in this particular text box. Click on Label, and then go to the user form and click and drag to create your label. You can change the label's text by clicking on the label and typing in some new text. The font is a little small, but you can change that by going down to Font and clicking the button that has three little dots. I will select a size 22 font. Oh, that looks a little big. Let's change it to 18. We still need to create text boxes where the user can input the initial velocity and the time. Also, we will need to create a text box that will display the height of the ball to the user. We can quickly create new text boxes and labels by selecting both the text box and label we just created. Hold the Control key, copying this label and text box by typing Control C, and then pasting by typing Control V. Just like with the first text box we created, we need to give descriptive names to the three new text boxes. I'll call the second text box initVel, which will store the initial velocity of the ball. The next text box will be called timeElapse, and this will store the amount of time that has elapsed since the ball was thrown. And finally, I'll change the last text box to heightAnds. That will display the answer to the user about how high the ball is at that time. I also would like to increase the font size in the text box so the values input by the user will be the same size as the label's font size. I also need to adjust the labels. The final controls that we need to create are two command buttons. The first command button will calculate the ball's height, and the second command button will close the user form. I'll increase the size of my user form and select Command button from the toolbox palette. Just drag out the size of the command button you wish to create. I'm going to call this first command button Run button. And this will be the button that will be clicked when I want to calculate the height of the ball. I'll change the text on the command button and change the font size to create a new command button. We can simply copy and paste and drag the second button to its new location. I'm going to rename the second button quit button. We need to write some VBA code that will be executed when the command buttons are clicked. If you double-click on any control on the user form, a window will appear with a blank sub-procedure for each control that you've clicked on. For example, let's click on Run button, Quit button, and the text box Height Ands. Notice that three blank sub-procedures have been created. In front of each of these sub-procedures is the term private. This limits the sub-procedure's scope to the module where it is written. In the past, we've only created public sub-procedures, which can be used in any other module in the VBA project. All sub-procedures by default are public, so we do not need to explicitly write public when creating sub-procedures previously. For now, just leave the word private in front of the sub-procedure. The run button underscore click sub-procedure is the code that will be executed when the run button is clicked. I've gone ahead and inserted some code that will calculate the height of the ball every time the run button is clicked. Four variables are declared: h0, which is the initial height of the ball, v0, the initial velocity of the ball, t, which is the time since the ball has been thrown, and g, the gravitational constant. We obtain h0 by obtaining the value from the text box named initHeight using initHeight.value. We obtain the initial velocity input by the user in the text box named initVel using initVel.value and assigning that to v0. We obtain the time from the text box timeElapse using timeElapse.value and assigning that to t. And g is assigned the value -9.81. Next, the program will calculate the height of the ball. In this example, we will assume that the ball does not bounce once it hits the ground. The equation for the height of the ball is the initial height plus the initial velocity times t plus 1/2 g times t squared. If this quantity is greater than 0, it will be assigned to the text box named height ands. If the quantity is not greater than 0, that means the ball has hit the ground and the string ball hit ground will be assigned to the text box height ands. Whenever a new value is assigned to height ands, that is what will be displayed in the text box on the screen. When the quit button is clicked, we want the user form, which is named height calc, to disappear from the screen. We can accomplish this task by using the unload statement. We don't want our program to do anything every time height ands is changed, so we will remove this blank sub-procedure. Now that we've created the user form, we need a way to bring it into existence. To do this, we create a macro that will show the user form to the user. So we can insert a new module, and if we want to show the user form, we simply say heightcalc.show. When the macro name ball is executed, the custom dialog box that we created will appear. Try plugging in some values for the initial height, initial velocity, and time elapsed, and then click on the run button below. Every time we click on the run button, the height of the ball will be calculated. After we're finished, we'll click on the quit button and the custom dialog box will disappear. If you want the user form to automatically appear when you open the workbook, you can add an event handler. Click on this workbook in the project window, choose the workbook option from the drop-down menu. The workbook open sub-procedure is executed every time the workbook is opened. We want the height calc user form to run when the workbook is open, so we'll type inside the sub-procedure workbook open height calc dot show. I will save this workbook to the desktop. And close it. And now when we open this workbook, I'm going to enable the content. We see a user form automatically pops up.